It's the moment you've all been waiting for, maybe.
I love it. Yeah, this is the show where we have guests on and all have to sit on each other's laps, essentially.
This is cool, though.
So this is one of my good friends. This is Will Neff. If you watch the show on KTLA.com, there's a chance that you're a cord cutter, maybe. You're interested in digital content. You're up on the trends. Yep. So this interview is going to apply to you. We're going to talk just for a second about who you are, what you're into, what we've done together.
Cool.
And then we're going to do the rest of the show, the C block, before we get cut in. And you can see what's going on in the next hour of KTLA.com. But this is neat because I've been wanting to have you on the show for a while. You have been a digital impresario, I might say, on BuzzFeed, Full Screen, Hot Wheels, The Young Turks. I was there for some of those things, and it changed me. I will say that much. You are, I think, one of my favorite people to work with because you always go for it. Let's take a look at this clip. This is from Hot Wheels. This is from the show we did. And Robert, if you have it, good? Let's do it. Take a look.
Do you think you're going to be able to...
Don't bite my face, tiny Minky.
Okay.
All right, ready? Game time.
And then
this is the grossest smoothie of all time.
Which had bacon, peanut butter, what else was in it?
Crickets. Great, so far I like it.
Fish chips.
Very keto, yeah.
And
keto, yeah.
Jalapenos.
No!
Yeah,
no.
In effect, I'm in strange ways.
Is Jaden serving your smoothies?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Say this fast kiss stuff.
It's so hot.
It's so foul.
I forgot there's a jalapeno.
So
nasty.
Anyway, yeah,
but
like I said,
we appreciate the commitment.
Yeah, you always go for it.
Yeah, like a digital Steve-O.
And you know exactly. And a lot of the news recently, and one of the things I wanted to have you on and talk about is that digital media, in a lot of ways, feels like maybe the bottom just fell out, right?
Yeah.
In the last couple of weeks, 2,100 people have lost their jobs in digital media.
Yeah.
Machinima shut down. Vice laid off people. BuzzFeed laid off a ton of people. When you look at the clip that we just showed, are you surprised?
Yes and no. I think that digital obviously had this amazing moment, especially like BuzzFeed when I was there, when we did have this huge audience, and I think people were really impressed by the number of views we were pulling down. But I think the problem was because we were doing so well, there was this expectation that because we had such a huge audience that there would be money in this in the future. And I don't think investors and money men really put in the time to realize that there wasn't black ink there.
Sure.
And so they kind of just threw money at the problem. While I was at BuzzFeed, BuzzFeed took two separate $200 million angel investments from NBC Universal, and I don't think they ever got out from under them.
Yeah.
And so I think the company culture changed immediately, where all of a sudden people whose whole business was to make, you know, how are we going to make a Cheetos video that does 100 million views?
Right.
All of a sudden, it was like, how are we going to make money on
it? And I think the thing that's odd is that now that those companies don't exist, I mean, they obviously there was like individual creators and stuff like that, and they make a ton of stuff, but there were a lot of pieces of content that we all looked at every single day that were being made by these places that just aren't going to make that anymore.
Yeah.
And I think that's obviously that's why we at KTLA are trying to do this digital stuff. But it really is, it's a crazy thing, and you see Disney trying to get into it.
Right.
And I'm curious if you have any thoughts on like what they can do to make it work.
Yeah, well, so.
And if you do, a lot of people will have money for you.
Yeah. And also, we're going to take notes. We're going to take notes real quick so that we can also know.
Here's the secret sauce. No, I think the model to emulate right now is Twitch. I think Bezos is a very smart man, and I think Twitch obviously put in a lot of infrastructure in making the revenue stream the highlight of what they do.
Sure.
Right from the ground up, the focus was how can you, the viewer, individually support the creator you like monetarily? How can you tip them? How can you interact with them every day? And because of that baseline, creators on Twitch are actually making a pretty successful level at a lot of different levels of fame and output. You know, there's someone who with, you know, 2,000 subscriptions who is making a pretty healthy living as opposed to a ninja who's making
it's wild. It's a crazy world that we live in for sure. So but you don't think it was our fault that it all went?
No, I
didn't make good enough content. That wasn't the issue?
No, I don't think it was our fault. I think it was this question of scale, right? I think BuzzFeed functioned pretty well as a small scale operation. But then when this idea was like, let's make cogs, let's bigger this business, let's put it in every home in America and we'll have BuzzFeed BuzzFeed plushies, and people will.
Plushies.
Yeah, it just wasn't
the
there.
Voice of BuzzFeed is really it's compelling.
Yeah, that was my Zay Frank.
Very
sounds. Yeah, I'll
always
sign up.
I thought it was a friendly website. So, it seems very
nice. The first time I actually met Zay Frank, the voice of BuzzFeed, I was at a urinal, actually.
Oh, okay,
and he came
cool.
up and he's like, hey, you're Will.
Oh, he touched you. Yeah, he touched you.
He's a great guy, though.
I feel uncomfortable by you telling this story and involving me in it.
I feel uncomfortable looking at my shirtless photos.
So, by the way, this was going to be my first question.
Yeah, sure.
I was like, I don't know what you do, but I understand that this is hard to get.
Natalie is on our on Will's
Instagram. These are hard to get.
Instagram.
That came from that keto shake you had with the
crickets. That must have been.
This is crickets and jalapenos, guys. If you're trying to get
crickets,
abs.
Yeah, it'll just clear you right out.
These are interesting photos. What?
You model a lot, yeah.
Did you know there was abs under there? I surely
did. I am sweating on camera.
Oh my.
This is such a fun game when people look through your Instagram with you and you're like,
you. Oh,
I am mortified for what I put up. Yeah, this is how people do it.
I mean, you have a lot of followers on that there gram.
Yep. Yeah,
and you're doing all kinds of stuff. What else is happening for you
right here?
Yeah, look.
Did you have blonde hair?
Oh yeah, that was.
I did. I was.
This
I
was my first sexy photo. Be gentle.
Yeah.
Oh, this is good. I think we should do a segment where you roast people on their Instagram.
Yeah,
in front of them.
Just gotta pull it up,
boom,
man.
Roasted.
That's awesome.
No,
this
so
is also
I kind
interesting
of
content.
For a while slid into like. What it meant to be an influencer, and I guess I kind of was like, well, I gotta do sexy stuff, man, right? And I had a lot of friends who were photographers. And
You were very blonde, I remember.
Very
you came in
blonde.
One day on full screen, and you were just all of a sudden a very blonde guy.
Yeah.
And we were like, is he?
Zac Efron just did that, so you might want to do it again.
I kind of loved it. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you. If you're thinking about
dying.
No, it
looks great. It's on the surface if you want to pull it up.
This guy looks like he shouldn't go within 300 yards of a school, though.
It's kind of like a sexy Jeffrey Dahmer that I had.
Hello, again, Zac Efron. I was playing Ted Bundy.
You're
it might
right.
Just be a
You're
thing.
Right. Maybe that's
Serial
an uncapitalized.
It is.
It's the boy in the closet.
Oh, well,
the
so
boy in the closet.
Among all the stuff that we've already talked about, we've done a lot of shows together where we've just like talked about things that are going on. Shows maybe similar to the show that we're on right now. Mm-hmm. So we figured that it wouldn't be the same if we didn't bring you on to talk about the show and participate in it.
Yes.
We don't want to just show real sexy pics of your chest.
Sure.
Although some people probably really enjoyed that.
Don't Adam Levine this, please. Please leave your shirt on.
I'm floundering, pop the top off.
Do you remember when you ripped your, you did. There's a video of you ripping your shirt off at a club, I believe. Yeah.
Of course that exists.
Anyway.
So we want you to sit around and do the news with us.
Yeah.
Sure, I'd love
Do we have a cut in too soon, or can we do some of the stories right now?
We got 6 minutes to do some content.
Let's do it.